Well, summer's on the way, and to celebrate, TVNZ is launching a new barbecue reality show, Cooks on Fire, tonight right after 7 sharp. Self-proclaimed Kiwi experts of the hot plate will battle it out for the inaugural win.
What makes a good barbecue? Good company, a dab hand on the tools, and the best New Zealand grass-fed meat you can find. And that's why the good folk at Silver Fern Farms have partnered with us to bring you the Silver Fern Farms 7 sharp Steak Off.
Steak Off! Jeremy v Hillary in a ding-dong battle of the sizzle!
I'm actually feeling quite confident. The last two competitions that Hillary and I have competed in, kitchen-based competitions, I've won.
I'm a little bit nervous. I don't mind admitting it, because Jeremy has been quite successful in our kitchen and cooking challenges lately.
This, oddly enough, is really my event.
There's something about guys and barbecues, you know?
Steak cooking is what I do. All right, straight into the meat. Beautiful looking eye fillet.
Oh, mine feels awfully cold. I thought I'd left this out.
I've got the Barbie mate and the Barbie boss.
These do feel very cold. Yours feels room temperature.
Well, that's strange, isn't it? So important, the preparation going into it, isn't it?
It's always nice to have quality ingredients. Steak, obviously, and then quality olive oil.
I think it's really important that your steak starts at the right temperature.
Me too, which is why I'm slightly concerned mine's so cold. When you've got quality meat, you only really need salt and pepper. You're doing a sort of Japanese-infused situation.
You find that this is not just olive oil, it's less salt.
Oh, absolute amateur.
The main thing is that you cook it from room temperature. That's just such an important aspect of cooking.
Oh, God.
I'm massaging the meat.
We're ready to barbecue.
We're ready to barbecue.
Great.
Welcome to the Silver Fern Farms 7 Sharp Steak Off. Ready, steady, okay. Barbecue.
Straight in there with that. Straight in there with that. Bit of this. And down.
Okay, what is going on here, team? We've got some meat on. Hillary, tell me a little bit about this thing right here.
Well, this is obviously the tool belt with quality ingredients to season my steak with. I've kept it really simple.
Tell me.
I've got cracked pepper, ooh, I've got some nice sea salt, I've got some quality olive oil, but I've gone lid up. I don't want it to be overcooked. I'm a bit concerned about putting the lid down.
I have questions, but we'll get to that in a second. This looks like you've done this before.
I've done this before.
So I'm going to expect it to be the perfect steak.
Well, I hope so. I want to impress you. And what's more, I want to beat him.
Tell me a bit about this technique that you've got here.
I always think you've got to shut the lid because I think the smoke is part of it. I think you want the smoke to be working around in that steak, and I think it keeps the flavour in.
Yes.
That's my vibe.
He's using his hands, which is really selling it.
I put on salt, pepper, a little bit of soy sauce, and a little bit of olive oil.
A bit of soy sauce?
Super salty on the outside, crispy on the outside, a little bit of burnt, a little bit of char, something cancerous.
Purity and a little bit dirty, that's what I'm getting.
See, I'm coming up here, I'm coming up, I've got a change.
Oh, oh.
Coming up for a change.
Here we go.
It needs to change.
It's looking pretty good.
There's a lot of chat. Nothing new there.
Well, I'm looking forward to trying it later on because the proof is in the tea.
Barbecue's at the right temperature. I felt like my steak started at the right temperature. I was happy with the way that I seasoned it.
I was a bit concerned about the temperature of my meat, which was really, really cold.
Let's just say that Hillary's gonna struggle to bring her steak up to temperature. I made sure that things are gonna be difficult for her and easier for me. She had it coming.
Jeremy was doing really inappropriate things to his meat.
Done. Okay.
He hasn't even let it rest. Wrapped up like a little baby in a blanket. Here we go. Should we wrap it up some more? Yes! Why Why not? And you just sit it out on the plate to get cold?
I can sit out and get a little bit cold. I mean, I normally would cover it slightly, but I don't have any implements to do that.
Here you go. Here's...
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, good sir. Bring those puppies to me.
There we are.
Let's do the sponge test to begin with. Good spring.
Thank you.
Are you well rested?
Yes.
I'm going to start with a gentle slice. Oh, hello.
Look at that.
I feel like you've done the steak justice. I mean, if Hillary was here, she'd be in trouble.
I know. She's still resting hers. This is the problem.
Oh.
She could be resting hers all night, and I don't think it's going to better that one.
Whoa. That's big talk. Shall we see? Hillary?
Coming.
Beautiful looking.
Thank you
beautiful
so much. I prefer my steak rare, so I hope you do.
I'm going to give it the old sponge test. Oh, yes, it's got a lovely spring in its step.
I can hear it mooing.
Oh. That looks so perfect.
Doesn't it?
Only one of these steaks can be the championship steak. So the winner of the steak off. Which steak was the purest, most beautiful form of itself? It was Hillary's. So Hillary, you are the inaugural champion of the International Intergalactic Steak Competition.
Thank you so
congratulations.
Much. I'm so, so proud.
Hillary takes the win and Jeremy's left a loser.
Let's just say both steaks were really, really good. Like, I think my steak was just as good, maybe if not a little bit better than Hillary's, but she has a way with people sometimes and they kind of just end up judging in her favour. It was probably a popularity contest rather than a steak contest.
It feels like a win for women, and also it really feels like a win for the good guy. Because it's obvious to me now that Jeremy did try and cheat, and I won anyway. So the victory is really, really sweet. Is there anything I'd like to say to Jeremy? Yes, there is. Don't cheat.